In this lesson, we're going to learn how to import a Houdini digital asset into the Unreal Editor. To do this, we're going to click on the Import button. We're going to go find our asset and open that into our scene. Now, it isn't in the view here. We've got to drag it over. And once we let go there, then the Houdini engine will, under the surface, kick in and start building the asset. So this is a table. Let's zoom in a little closer on there. Now it's still compiling the shaders. This asset has shaders built in for the tables and the chairs and all the pieces, and they're currently being built. Okay, so now we have all of the assets in. Now if this was a normal game asset, this is the asset you would have available for your game, and you would, if you wanted to change it, you would have to go back to the artist and ask them to rework the asset. Because this is a Houdini digital asset, this asset has controls that you can work with right here in the editor. And if we scroll down, we can begin to find some of these. Let's push that up. You see we have various instanced objects, the various chairs and details, and they help define the results. So what we can do is we can go into here, we can do things like, for instance, change the endpoint of the table, and that will make the table a little longer. We can play with the width if we want to, maybe make a wider table. So all of these things can be controlled here, and as we make these edits, under the surface the Houdini engine recooks the asset and delivers it to the editor. We can also do things like, for instance, we can randomly remove chairs. We'd have to pull a percentage value down, and then you get a few of them disappearing. We can also spin the chairs so that we get just a little bit of random spinning on them, just so they look a little bit more less organized. You can also add props to the table. Now, as it first puts these in, it's going to again compile the various shaders that work with this asset. And using this, we can also play with the density of how many props we want. We can have a seed for moving them around to get the look that we want, and we can do various things like min and max scale. So here you can see the results of the asset, and the artist here in Unreal has the ability to play with and control this however they want. And this allows you to keep making creative decisions as you develop and improve your game.